Imagine if a friend is running free in a dense forest and suddenly vanishes in thin air in front of your eyes. Would you believe it? Yeah, it may sound crazy, but it has really happened. The story goes on like this. There was a kind shoemaker whose name was James Burne Worson, who lived in Leamington, Warwick, England. He had a little shop in one of the byways leading off to the roads or to Warwick. As living in an English town, he was addicted to alcohol, but was a humble and honest man. He wanted attention, and also being a good athlete, he decided to go on a match against nature. He was challenged by one of his friends to run from Leamington to Coventry and then run the whole way back. It wasn't an easy task. He had to run about 20 miles. He had given the freedom for regular breaks. This was on the third day of September in 1873. He set out at once. The man with whom he had made the bet, whose name is not remembered, accompanied by Bram Weiss, a linen draper, and Hammerson Burns, a photographer, went with him, following in a light cart or wagon. For several miles, Worson went on very well in ease. The three men in the wagon kept a short distance in the rear, giving him occasionally a friendly cough or encouragement as the spirit moved them. Suddenly, in the very middle of the roadway, not a dozen yards from him, and with their eyes full upon him, the man seemed to trip upon something, and with a cry before touching the ground, he was vanished into the thin air. The three men tried to find James in the forest, but no trace was found. After remaining at the spot for some time, with aimless irresolution, the three men returned to the Leamington with their astonishing story to the town. Afterwards, they were taken in custody as people thought the three men had done something to James, but with no evidence, they were set free. Now, that it was written by one of the great storytellers in modern literature wasn't necessarily mean that it doesn't mean that it's untrue. Granted, some of what Bryce wrote was pure fiction. It's especially interesting to note that Ambrose Bryce himself also disappeared under mysterious circumstances. At the age of 77, he traveled to Mexico and eventually caught up with and joined the infamous revolutionary Pancho Villa. A letter from him dated December 26, 1879, addressed to his good friend Blanche Barnington, alluded to his upcoming itinerary in its closing remark. As to me, I leave here tomorrow for an unknown destination. He was never seen or heard from again. The various possibilities for Bryce's fate, such as suicide, murder, illness, etc., notwithstanding what might have happened to James Worson if he did indeed exist. The popular answer may be for the dimension. A dimension is not a place, it is simply a direction of travel, down, back and forth. These are dimensions. In physics, when smart people like Stephen Hawking talk about extra-dimensional space, what they are referring to is the mathematical addition to a three-dimensional reality. When we experience the world, we are exposed to three directions in which we can travel, or three dimensions we can measure: height, width and depth. What higher mathematics does is it adds to other dimensions to this framework. In the case of so-called fourth dimension, there are higher dimensions. We don't experience them because they are wrapped up in subatomic sized geometric shapes or realm other than the reality we can see, whether that can be heaven or hell or another universe or even another timeline. We can come up with ideas from where someone like Worson might have gone. Teleportation can also be an answer, and there have been some strange accounts around the world of people vanishing only to appear somewhere else. One of them is the curious case of Damodar Kedkar of Pune, India. In April 1928, Kedkar reportedly teleported over 60 miles, and his reappearance was witnessed by his governess, who wrote about the experience in her journal. In this case, the subject or perhaps the victim reappeared in the short order, though they were somewhat removed when they did. In the case of Worson, he was never seen again. So, what if he teleported by whatever means to another dimension, another universe, or even another timeline? What if he teleported to another planet or just another region of space? Another example can be taken in the Bermuda Triangle or the Devil's Triangle, that anything goes into the triangular area found between Florida, Bermuda Island and Puerto Rico has never returned back. Planes, ships which pass through have never returned back or have any traces. Portal to quantum realm where the planes and ships could become smaller. In the case of James Worson, the place he was vanished may be a portal to quantum realm, but as per scientists, quantum realm doesn't exist.